This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about ordering decimals. So this is a pretty easy process. Here's how it goes. I've got four numbers, and I want to arrange them in a list from smallest to largest. The numbers are 20.56, 19.7, 20.23, and 20.2. So the first step to make it easy to compare these numbers is going to be to write them in a vertical column. I want to make sure I line up my decimal points when I do this. So I've got 20.56. Directly under that, I'm writing 19.7. The decimal points are lined up one under the other. I'll add my next number to the list. That's 20.23. And my last number is 20.2. So the decimal points are all lined up in a vertical column. And now to find out which is the smallest of these numbers, I'll go over to the left of the numbers, the left end, which is going to be the tens column, and I'll compare all the digits in the tens column. If I find a digit that's smaller than the others, then that's going to tell me which is the smallest number. So I've got a 2, a 1, a 2, and a 2. So that means 19.7 is going to be the smallest of those four numbers. So I can start putting these numbers in order. The smallest number is going to be 19.7, and I'll cross 19.7 off of my vertical column. And now I'll do the process again. Well, I've got twos in that tens column. Moving over one column to the units column, I've got nothing but zeros, so I can't compare those. Moving over one more column, now to the right of the decimal point, to the tenths column, I've got a 5, a 2, and a 2. So those last two numbers are going to be smaller than the one with the 5 in them, the 20.56. I want to compare those last two numbers, 20.23 and 20.2. So I'll add a 0 at the end of this 20.2, and now both of these numbers have the same number of places, of decimal places. So I can go over one more decimal place. I can go over to the hundredths column, and I see a 3 and a 0. That means the number with the 0, the 20.20, is the next smallest number. So I can write that in. I'm not going to bother with that last 0 because it wasn't even part of the original number. So 19.7 is less than 20.2. I want to find the next number. If I go back and compare what I have left, I've got in that tenths column again, I've got one number with a 5 and one number with a 2. So the number with the 2 is the next smallest number. That's 20.23. I'll cross that number off of my vertical column. The only thing I have left is 20.56. So that's going to be my largest number. And now I've got my numbers arranged in order from smallest to largest. 19.7 is less than 20.2, and that's less than 20.23, and that's less than 20.56. Okay, that's basically the whole process. Take care. I'll see you next time.